the remote forests of Siberia. Tunguska. That day, the Earth experienced one of the greatest cosmic events of the 20th century. A blast heard from 600 kilometers away leveled 80 million trees. This wasn't just a shockwave. This was an unsolvable puzzle that slipped through the grasp of science. It was 1,000 times stronger than the Hiroshima atomic bomb, yet it didn't even leave a crater, the evidence of an explosion that vanished. Today, we're going to unlock the three major mysteries behind this event. Section 1. The Unseeing World and the Delayed Discovery. Accounts from the local Evenki people describing what happened at the moment of the explosion reflect the terror of the event. While a shepherd recounted, "The sky caught fire. The wind threw me to the ground." Seismic devices in England and the US, hundreds of kilometers away, also recorded the blast. However, due to political turmoil, wars in the Russian Empire, and the extreme isolation of the site, this global event was only addressed 19 years later, in 1927. The Soviet scientist Leonid Kulik went to the region hoping to find a meteor crater. However, the scene Kulik found was utterly confusing. All the trees were leveled in a fan shape, radiating outward from the center. But at the center? The trees at the center were standing bolt upright. Only their branches were burned and stripped. This indicated that the shockwave came from above. Kulik dedicated the rest of his life to finding where this mysterious object had landed. But he could not find a single piece of metal, not even a trace of a crater. It was as if the event had vaporized several kilometers above the ground. Section 2. Science's two conflicting theories. The scientific community's initial reaction was simple. It must have been a meteor. But there were no remnants. This void gave rise to two main scientific theories. The first theory was that a large stone asteroid approached the Earth and, unable to withstand the friction and pressure in the atmosphere, fragmented and exploded 8 to 10 kilometers high in the air. The explosion was so high that it sent all its energy to the Earth as a shockwave, but a crater was not opened. The problem? Even if a 1,000-ton rock fragment exploded in the air, there should have been remnants that fell to the ground. Magnetic and chemical tests conducted found no discernible trace of space rock. The second theory was more elegant. It was the core of a comet. Comets are mostly composed of ice, frozen gases, and dust. The explosion of ice at high altitude could explain the complete vaporization and disappearance without leaving any solid remnants behind. This perfectly explained the blast, no evidence situation. However, this theory also faced a single problem. For an explosion this powerful, the comet would have had to be massive. Section 3. The darkest theories and traces of conspiracy. When science couldn't provide a definitive answer, attention turned to other possibilities. And the shadow of the 20th century's greatest genius began to envelop this mysterious event. Nikola Tesla. The year was 1908. While the Tunguska explosion occurred, Nikola Tesla was at the peak of his wireless energy transmission experiments at Wardenclyffe Tower in New York. Tesla claimed he could transmit this energy thousands of kilometers away. The conspiracy theory was simple. Tesla directed the energy toward a target. It was a simple experiment. Or, more terrifyingly, it was a weapons test. The explosion's energy was immense, but there was no metal evidence of an extraterrestrial origin left behind. Just like an energy blast. The popularity of this theory increased further with the anomalies detected at the site of the event. The teams that followed Kulik recorded that the trees in the area were growing at an astonishing and abnormal rate. Claims of finding traces of radioactive elements in the soil and trees only added to the mystery. Could this have been the first evidence of a potentially dangerous energy, not yet understood by humanity, spinning out of control, rather than a natural disaster? Conclusion: a century-old mystery. The Tunguska event continues to remain one of the greatest puzzles in modern science. The lack of evidence, the sheer power of the event, and these wild theories, all fuel an uncertainty that has persisted for over a century. All that remains at the site is a ghost forest made up of fallen trees. And this forest silently asks us, was the thing that exploded in the Siberian sky in 1908 truly an innocent piece of ice from space? Or was it the greatest secret human experiment ever recorded in history? Share your thoughts in the comments. Which theory do you believe more to solve this mystery? Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell. See you in our next mystery video.